Bienvenidos sean en este día que estamos en el año 2022.
Welcome, this day we are 2022.
Amen. Yeah. ¿Saben qué? Que el año 2021 ya pasó, todos sabemos, ¿sí? Y dice, les voy a recordar lo que dice la palabra, dice, que aquí yo hago cosa nueva en este 2022 y pronto saldrá a la luz, dice la palabra. Entonces nosotros necesitamos creer que este año será diferente.
So this is 2022, and so we're just reminded this morning of God's word. It tells us that he is doing a new thing. Amen. He is doing a new thing in 2022. 2021 now is gone. It's in the rear view, right? The only reason we look in the past is to see how far God has brought us, but we are now focusing our eyes forward on 2022.
¿Ustedes creen o no creen? ¿Sí? Sí, así es. Y para ustedes que nos están mirando, bienvenidos una vez más a la Iglesia del Encuentro.
Amen. Those that are watching online, again, welcome to the Encounter Church. You are in the right place. You are home.
Bueno, estamos aquí la hermana Jenny y yo para darle los anuncios de lo que está sucediendo aquí en nuestra iglesia. Y queremos comunicar que los martes y jueves tenemos tribu.
So this, we are going to get ready to go into announcements. This week we have lots of things that are happening at the Encounter Church. We have our weekly Bible study on Tuesday, and then of course we have tribes happening throughout the week. So if you haven't gotten plugged into a tribe yet, this is your year, 2022, you guys. Get plugged into a tribe. Speak to a leader if you're not sure, you know, where you fit. If we've got tribes happening all over the county. So definitely want you guys to get involved, whether you're here in person or online. We also have tribes that meet on Zoom.
La ID se transmite en el Instagram y en el Facebook, para si usted se quiere conectar, ahí nos puede encontrar a las 7 de la noche.
So if you want to check us out again on Instagram or Facebook, that way you can stay apprised of everything that's happening throughout the week. We don't want you guys to miss it.
¿Saben qué? Les quiero recordar algo. Están muy serios todos aquí. Algo está pasando en la iglesia del encuentro.
Amen.
¿Sí? Miren, algo está pasando en la iglesia del encuentro.
Yeah. She said, things are getting, you guys are really serious this morning. Let's be joyful. Amen. Something is happening at the Encounter Church. Amen. Amen.
Les quiero comunicar algo que el hermano Isaac no sabe todavía. El hermano Julio tampoco sabe. Y el pastor tampoco sabe. Pero les vamos a dar un anuncio. El jueves estuvieron llamando y dejándonos saber que están pidiendo clave del Zoom y cómo es eso del Zoom, cómo es eso del jueves a través de las tribus en Los Cabos, San Lucas. Imagínense nada más. Ahora lo están pidiendo ellos, no nos están buscando en Los Cabos, San Lucas. Estamos en Durango, estamos en Oaxaca. Estamos conectándonos en Jalisco y ahora nos están buscando en Los Cabos, San Lucas. Eso es que algo está pasando en la iglesia El Encuentro.
Amen. Amen. So my sister was giving an amazing testimony of how God has been moving in tribes. And in the specific tribe that she was talking about is that, and nobody knows this yet. Nobody had, she hadn't shared this with anyone, and so you guys are the first to hear. But people are asking for the Zoom password to get onto their tribe from Cabo San Lucas, from Durango, from
Jalisco,
all kinds of different places, you guys. We are reaching the world, amen? You guys are reaching the world.
Así es. Y todo lo que sembraron cuando empezaron las tribus, ahora estamos cosechando.
Yeah, everything that was sown when we began the tribes, now we are reaping the harvest.
Y también eso les quiero dejar saber. Lo que sembramos, cosechamos. Y es tiempo de hablarles acerca de la ofrenda, aprovechando la siembra y la cosecha. Miren, bueno, hermana, diga. Yeah.
So right now, we want to go ahead and transition into our offering, our generosity. You know, it's, again, because of everything that was sown, right? We are now reaping. We know that, you know, some water, some sow, but God is the one that brings the increase. Amen? Amen.
Amen. Estoy por darles un testimonio acerca de lo que es el diezmo y la ofrenda. Todos sabemos que la palabra es la verdad y que nosotros tenemos que proclamar lo que dice la palabra. Y en este año, bueno, en este año podemos mirar tanto mi marido y yo que en nuestro negocio o en el negocio nos debían bastante dinero, ¿sí? Desde el 2019 nos estaban tenían una deuda atrasada con nosotros.
So we know that God's word is truth. Amen. God's word is always true. He is faithful to his word. And she is getting ready to tell a testimony about her, specifically her and her husband at work. They were owed an amount of money.
Y recordaba yo lo que dice el Señor, que el Señor va a reprender al devorador, ¿sí? Que nosotros tenemos que diezmar, tenemos que traer los diezmos a la folía. Y eso lo han recordado, lo han escuchado bastante de mi boca en este año.
Amen. And she's saying that, you know, we know that God rebukes the devourer, right? And that when we are continually faithful, as she and her husband have been faithful in giving their offerings and giving their time and giving their talent and giving their treasure, and remembering that promise, right? Because it's God's promises to us are yes and amen, but there's some times that we need to remind ourselves, what is it that God has promised me? Amen? And so that's what she's sharing.
Recordaba y pasaba cuando habla de la ofrenda y yo... Cuando miraba esa cantidad que nos debían, yo le decía, Señor, usted dice que traigan los diezmos a la alfolí y hay alimento en mi casa y que el devorador usted lo va a reprender. Yo no sé cómo usted va a traernos ese dinero, pero nosotros ya dimos ese diezmo de ese dinero que lo tienen allá.
Amen. Amen. And so she, you know, was sharing that she doesn't know how God was going to do it, but she knows that God is faithful to his word. She reminded God, you know what? You said that if I am faithful in my giving, that you will make sure that you rebuke the devourer, that I will have enough, that there will be plenty. You are my provider, right? So just going back again and reminding ourselves of God's word.
Y resulta que eso sucedió desde el 2019. Y en este año 2021 podemos recuperar todo. Todo, todo. Y eso es para que nosotros podamos mirar que aunque pase el tiempo, nosotros podemos seguir confiando en Dios, de que si nosotros le damos a Dios lo que es de Dios y al César lo que es del César, Dios respalda su palabra y Él no miente en su palabra. Dios nos va a bendecir todavía más de lo que nosotros estamos siendo bendecidos.
Amen. Amen. So this happened way back in 2019. And 2021 is when she saw God's promise come to pass in her life. And it doesn't matter, you know, if you're believing on something that you haven't seen in the natural happen yet. It's okay. God's already done the work. We haven't seen it yet in the natural, but we got to believe that it's done. Because as she was sharing, God is not a liar. He is faithful. He is true to his word. Whether it happens right now or whether it's still, we're still waiting to see it happen, but it's done. Amen. The work is done. We just continually remind ourselves, God, you are faithful. God, this is what your promise says to me, Lord. This is what you've declared over my family. Amen. So again, you guys, we may be shaken. We may be, pushed around by the enemy, but we know already that he has overcome. And if nothing else, if we can't get excited about anything else this morning, just get excited about the fact that he is on the throne, you guys. No matter if we see that we have enough or we don't, you guys, he is Jehovah Jireh, our provider. He is Jehovah Rapha, our healer. He is what we need him to be. He is the great I am, you guys. He is El Shaddai, Lord God Almighty. He is God all by himself. Amen? Come on, you guys, let's get excited. We're 2022. We're marching forward. It is outpour this year. Somebody scream, outpour, Lord. Outpour, Lord. We're ready, Jesus.
Bueno, tenemos cuatro maneras de dar su diezmo, ofrenda, lo que usted quiera dar a la iglesia del encuentro. Los que están en las redes sociales igualmente pueden traer sus donaciones. Tenemos las cuatro maneras de dar y son bienvenidos.
Yes, four ways to give, you guys, so they're on the screen, but definitely give. Time, talent, and treasure, you guys. God is faithful always. God bless, and let's get ready to worship. Amen?
Woo!
Amen.
Hallelujah, come on. Let's put those hands together.
Amen.
This This is the first Sunday of 2022. How many of you are excited? Come on.
I was buried beneath my shame, but who could carry that kind of weight? Oh, it was my tomb till I met you.
Come on, I was breathing.
I was breathing, but not alive. And all my failures I've tried to hide. Oh, it was my turn till I met you.
Come on, let's all sing it out in this place.
You called my name and I ran out of that grave. Mercy has saved my soul, and now your freedom is all that I know. Oh, the old made new, Jesus, when I met you. Pecado me rescataste, en tu gloria cadenas se rompe. Vivía solo y sin consuelo, ahora soy ciudadano del cielo.
Come on again, de mi pecado.
De mi pecado me rescataste, en tu gloria cadenas se rompe. Vivía solo consuelo, ahora soy ciudadano del cielo.
Tú me sanaste, estar unido, Jesús, por tu amor yo respiro. Tengo un futuro, ahora veo, porque tu voz me habló. Pecado me rescataste, en tu gloria cadenas se rompe,
sentía solo y sin consuelo. Ahora soy ciudadano de cielo. De mi pecado me rescataste. En tu gloria cadenas se rompen. Vivía solo y sin consuelo. Ahora soy ciudadano del cielo.
Has already been prepared. So let's just continue to invite the Spirit of the Lord right here in this place. Yes, Jesus, we thank you, Father. We thank you, Jesus, God, for this past year, God, for bringing us through, God. We thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the opportunity to be here, God, on this first Sunday, God, of the year, Lord. And we pray, God, that this Sunday, Jesus, Lord, would set the tone, God, for the rest of the year, Lord. That right here, right now, God, our pastor's been talking about a season of outpour, God. And I pray, Lord, right here that we would pour out, God. Pour out right here, God, our spirit of worship. Pour out right here, Jesus, Lord, our spirit of praise, God. Lord, and that we would go after it, God. We would go after it, Jesus. We would stop at nothing, Lord. We're going to go after it right here, right now. Come on, how many of you are ready to go after it? Come on. And it can be anything. It can be your miracle. It could be your breakthrough. It could be the outpour. It could be somebody in your family you're trying to reach. It could be somebody that's been on your heart for a long time. It could be the prodigal. It could be, come on, somebody. It could be that healing. So let's go after it. Whatever it is for you, let's go after it. Come on, maybe it is just going deeper. Maybe it's just going deeper in the Lord. So if that's you right here, come on, let's just lift up our hands.
Glory knows.
knows no measure or refrain. And it's bursting past the borderlines of space.
Come on, every voice in this place.
Jesus, enthroned upon the praises of our hearts. Jesus, you're the King and you're the center of it all. There is no name that's reaching past the margins. He's calling sons and daughters back to him. And as he says, you can hear the roars of heaven as prodigals are coming home again. Oh, the triumph of his name will never end. Oh, Jesus, enthroned upon the praises of our hearts.
Come on, everybody, let's sing that out in this place. Come on, sing Jesus.
Jesus, you're the King and you're the center of it all.
Yes, you are. Come on, Jesus.
Jesus, enthroned upon the praises of our hearts.
Somebody stretch your arms out to him. Come on.
You're the center. You're the center. Lord, be the center. Oh, be the center.
Come on, Lord. We invite you right here, right now, God. We invite you right here, right now. Come on, now we sing this.
For every eye will see, every heart will know, there is no name above the name of Jesus. Death could not hold him down, no grave could keep him down. All sin and sickness bows to the name Jesus. For every eye will see, every heart.
Come on, every heart's gonna know in 2022. Come on. Come on.
The name of Jesus. Death could not.
Come on.
No grave.
Cause
all sin and sickness.
Come on, again, again, again. Come on.
For every eye.
Yes, come on.
Oh, every heart will know.
Stir it up
there
here. Come on.
There is no name above the name of Jesus. Death could not hold
him. Hey, come on.
No grave could keep him bound.
Oh. I feel like we need to do something in this place. How many of you are ready to go deeper? Let's lift up our hands. If that's you, come on. I feel like we need to do something. All ministers, pastors, can we just start praying over people? Is it okay if we get out of our seat and start kind of, how do I explain? Kind of start working in this atmosphere right here. I feel like we got to go deeper because we're just standing here, and the Spirit of God, He's moving, and if we don't move with Him, it's gonna get past us. So I wonder if we could get out of our seats, ministers and pastors, and begin to pray over those who have their hands up that want to go deeper. Is that okay if we do that? Oh, I don't think anybody's ready for this. Is that okay if we do that? Come on, I feel like I got to stand up for the presence of God that's in this place right now. I feel like I got to stand up for the presence of God that's moving in this place right now. If that is you, if you need something, maybe you need something. Maybe you need breakthrough. Come on, maybe there's somebody in this place that feels far from Him. You don't have to be embarrassed. You don't have to be ashamed. Come on. Let's begin to pray over those that have their hand up. And if you want to go deeper, we're enough with the surface worship this year. Enough with the lip service this year. Come on, we're going deeper. Come on, we're going past the margins. We're going past those lines of just standing here and waiting for a move of God. We're not going to wait anymore for a move of God. Come on, we're going to go after it. Come on, we're going to go after it. Let's go after it. Come on.
Every heart will know there is no name above the name of Jesus. Death could not hold.
Come on, somebody, go after it. Come on.
No grave.
Hey, come on.
All sin and sickness bound to the name of Jesus. For every eye will
see. Hey, come on.
And every heart will know. There is no name above the name of Jesus. Death could not hold Him down. No grave could keep Him bound. All sin and sickness bound to the name of Jesus.
Más de ti, Señor, en este lugar. Aleluya.
¿Quién está listo para un derramamiento? ¿Quién está listo? Who's ready for outpour? I don't know about you, but I'm ready for outpour. I'm ready for God to do what only He can do. Estoy listo para recibir algo nuevo del Señor. Aleluya. Dejo todo atrás. Dejo todo atrás. Aleluya. Y estoy entrando en 2022 con victoria, con un grito de júbilo, con un grito de esperanza. Porque yo sé que el Dios que yo sirvo es vivo y está presente en este lugar. No sé si ustedes lo conocen a mi Jesucristo, pero el Dios que yo sirvo es un Dios todopoderoso. I don't know if you know the Jesus that I know, but the Jesus that I know is all powerful and He is in this place. I'm ready for outpour. Who's ready for outpour? Hallelujah. Can you just lift your hands? Let's just lift your hands. Let's just worship Jesus. Vamos a alabar al Señor. Vamos a alabar al Señor porque Él es digno. Oh Señor, te alabamos, Señor. Te glorificamos, Señor. Eres digno, Señor. Aleluya. Aleluya. Muévete, Señor, libremente aquí en este lugar, Señor. Estamos aquí, Señor. Nuestros corazones están abiertos, Señor. Aleluya. Para recibir tu palabra, Señor. Aleluya. Para hacer tu voluntad. Lord Jesus, we are here right now. Hearts and minds open, Jesus, to do your will, Father. Because we know, Jesus, that you, Father, are in control, Lord Jesus. You lead us, God. You direct us, God. Where you go, we will follow, Jesus. Oh, Lord, have your way. Have your way. Have your way, Jesus. Hallelujah, Señor. Hallelujah. Gloria al Señor. Tu fidelidad es grande. Tu fidelidad incomparable es. Nadie como tú, bendito Dios. Grande es tu fidelidad. Tu fidelidad es grande. Tu fidelidad incomparable es. Nadie como tú, bendito Dios. Grande es tu fidelidad. Con manos en alto una vez más, aleluya. Tu fidelidad es grande. Tu fidelidad incomparable es. Nadie como tú, bendito Dios. Grande es tu fidelidad, oh Señor. Grande es tu fidelidad. Un aplauso fuerte al Señor. Let's give God a good round of applause. Celebramos la fidelidad de Dios en el año 2021. Y esperamos, aleluya, un gran movimiento del Espíritu Santo, un gran derramamiento del Espíritu Santo en 2022. Yo creo que el mundo está listo, amén. El mundo está listo para recibir algo nuevo, amén. Algo real, algo original, amén. I'm saying that I believe and I thank God for his faithfulness in 2021. But I thank God for the hope that we have for 2022. Amen. I believe the world is ready for something new. I believe the world is ready for something original. I believe the world is ready for something life-changing. Amen. The ordinary isn't going to do. We need extraordinary. Amen. Ordinary just ain't going to do. We need the extraordinary. We need to have God encounters. I was telling a pastor friend of mine this week, I said, you know, all the pomp and circumstance and the balloons and the lights and the smoke machines and the beauty of the temple and all that is great, you know, the invitations and everything that we can do to draw people to the house, all that's wonderful. But when people get to the Encounter Church, I want them to know that they have been in the presence of Almighty God. I want them to walk out of this place understanding that their lives have forever been changed by the presence of Almighty God. Amen. That's extraordinary. Estaba yo hablando con un amigo, con un pastor aquí en la comunidad este domingo o esta semana, y le estaba comentando que hay muchas cosas que podemos hacer, muchos diferentes programas que podemos planear, muchas diferentes cosas en las luces y el edificio y las fiestas que podemos hacer, pero lo importante, yo quiero que cada persona que entre en las puertas de esta iglesia, que se siente algo sobrenatural, que sabe, que yo quiero que ellos sepan que cuando salga de este edificio, que ellos estuve en la presencia de un Dios real, de un Dios poderoso. Quiero que ellos, aleluya, siente algo extraordinario, que sus vidas siempre eran cambiados por la experiencia que tuviste aquí en la iglesia del encuentro. ¿Por qué? Porque algo está pasando en la iglesia del encuentro. Something happening here. Some of you weren't here to hear Sister Rosie's testimony, but she was explaining how on the Thursdays, how God is moving in such a powerful way on our Thursday Zoom meetings. Brother Isaac told me a couple weeks ago, he says, Pastor, can you teach? I'm going to be unavailable, and Brother Julio's going to be unavailable. And I said, sure, I'll teach on Thursday. And I got on the Zoom meeting, and I saw faces I'd never seen before. All of a sudden, I saw these screens pop up. I said, I've never seen these people. I don't know who they are. I mean, I knew who Brother Pedro and Sister Rosie were and their family, but the other people, I said, who are these people? Come to find out that they're, I asked them, I said, well, can you introduce yourselves? I thought there's one or two people on the screen. I got 10 in one house, 12 in another house. And I was like, oh my God. I started getting nervous because, you know, my Spanish is, you know. And it's amazing what God is doing through the Encounter Church. You have no idea, but you're reaching people. She said in Los Cabos, San Lucas, Oaxaca, Durango. Wow. You know, that's something to get excited about. There's an outpour. And that's what Sister Rosie was talking about. That was a testimony she was giving. There's something happening here. Hay algo que está pasando aquí en la iglesia del encuentro. El testimonio de la hermana Rosie que nos dieron de los hermanos y las casas y las familias que están siendo alcanzados por el evangelio atrás de este Zoom. Amén. El otro día yo tuve la oportunidad de hacer, traer la enseñanza. Hermano Isaac me llamó y me dice, ¿sabes qué, pastor? Tú, si puedes hacer la enseñanza. Pues le dije, pues sí, yo voy. A mi sorpresa, cuando yo entré en el Zoom, había como 10 pantallas y ninguna de las personas, yo ni los conocí, no los he visto. Entonces, el hermano Pedro y su familia, sí. Pero los demás ni los conocí. Y había diferentes personas en diferentes estados que están buscando, que están buscando, que está buscando la palabra de Dios, que está buscando algo sobrenatural. Amén. Y estamos bendecidos que Dios está haciendo algo tan precioso en las vidas de muchas personas. Amén. Eso está pasando ahorita. Dios está derramando de su espíritu. Amen. God is bringing the increase. We believe that. Before I get started, I just want to let you know we thank God for all you that are here today. Thank you for those that are tuning in online. Listen, the rest of the week remains the same. Vacation's over. Okay? La vacación ya se pasó. Amen. El martes estamos aquí, estudio bíblico en inglés. Ya saben del schedule en Zoom. Tuesday, we're here. Bibles, listen, this year, we can't just be hearers of the word. We need to be doers of the word. Amen? We need to put to practice. We need to study God's word so we can put to practice what the word of God says. Because as we apply it to our lives, it's going to bring us success. Amen? Tuesday. Here at the church, 7 o'clock. Amen. Also, Wednesday mornings, we're going to be praying. Getting back into prayer. Wednesday morning, 5 a.m. A las 5 de la mañana, estamos aquí. Amen. Orando a las 5 hasta las 9 de la mañana. Amen. Every Wednesday. every Wednesday, 5 a.m. to 9 a.m. here at the Encounter Church. We're going to be praying. Amen. Next Saturday, we have a leadership conference. All those that want to get involved in leadership and volunteering, we want you to be here 9 a.m. to noon next Saturday here at the church. So we want you to be involved. We don't want you just to, you know, to be attenders. We want you to be participators. Amen. So everybody, you're invited to be here 9 a.m. to noon next Saturday. El próximo sábado vamos a estar aquí a las 9 de la mañana hasta las 12. Todos que quieren hacer que quieren participar en el liderazgo, quieren hacer un voluntario, amen, aquí en la iglesia del encuentro, vamos a estar a tener una junta, amen. Quiero comunicar a ustedes el visión que Dios nos ha puesto en nuestros corazones por la iglesia del encuentro a las 9 a.m. hasta las 12 el próximo sábado, este sábado que viene. Amén. Amén. Ok. Ahora, vamos a entrar en la palabra de Dios. Yo tengo algo en mi corazón que Dios ha puesto en mi corazón. Y este mes de enero vamos a comenzar con la enseñanza tocante del derramamiento que Dios está trayendo. Amén, al reino de Dios. Y es un proceso, así es que yo quiero que ustedes me siguen. Amén. Vamos a tener nuestro hermano pastor Mike Solorio con nosotros y también un pastor, hermano pastor Daniel Osegueda, va a traer la palabra de Dios en este mes y vamos a estar anunciando eso en las redes sociales. Pero quiero que ustedes que me siguen en este, en este camino durante el mes de enero, porque hay un proceso para llegar al derramamiento. Amén. Hay un proceso. Y este, lo que Dios ha puesto en mi corazón, no va a ser fácil. No va a ser fácil hoy lo que tengo que decir. Tal vez algunos de ustedes se lo van a sentir y le van a decir, ouch. Amén. Pero es un parte de lo que tenemos que pasar para que lleguemos al derramamiento. Amén. I'm saying that throughout this month we're going to begin with our sermon series for Outpour. And I believe that God is going to reveal to us some incredible things. We're going to have Pastor Mike Solorio with us. I believe the 16th he's going to be with us. And then we're going to have Pastor Daniel Osegueda he's going to be preaching a revival the 21st to the 23rd. Amen. But we're going to be speaking on this subject. Amen. And I'm going to start today with what the Lord has placed on me for this body of believers. And I'm going to warn you that this is not, in some points, going to feel too good. It's not going to feel too good. You ever been to the chiropractor? And you get to the chiropractor and sometimes they adjust you. It's kind of scary because your body goes in areas and places and twists and turns it's not meant to, right? But after, you feel good, right? You feel good. So in some points, this may not feel too good. I want to warn you. Some of you may say, ouch, right? But this is part of our journey to outpour. Because outpour is a journey, right? It's a journey that we're going to get to. Amen. We're going to get there together. So I'm going to invite you to the book of Joel, chapter 2. El libro de Joel, capítulo 2. Vamos a leer versículos 12 y 13. We're going to read verses 12 and 13. And then we'll pray. You can be seated for just a little while I remain standing. Joel 2, 12 and 13. It says like this. Therefore also now saith the Lord, turn ye even to me with all your heart, and with fasting, and with weeping, and with mourning. And rend your hearts, not your garments. Turn unto the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness, and repenteth him of the evil. Por eso pues ahora dice Jehová, convertíos a mí con todo vuestro corazón, con ayuno y lloro y lamento. Rasgad vuestro corazón, y no vuestros vestidos. Y convertíos a Jehová vuestro Dios, porque misericordioso es y clemente. Tardo para la ira y grande en misericordia, y que se duele del castigo. Amen. Jesus, we thank you. Be with us this morning, God. Speak to our hearts in Jesus' name. Habla nuestros corazones en el nombre de Jesucristo. Amen. Pueden ocupar sus lugares. The book of Joel is a prophetic book, right? It's also a poetic book. It's written by an Old Testament prophet within the works of what is considered to be called the Minor Prophets, the books of the Minor Prophets. And it strikes a pretty ominous tone. First chapter speaks of a locust invasion, the locust invasion that destroys the land. The locusts eat the land to desolation, eats the crops, the vegetation. Even the livestock of the people of Israel and their cattle suffer from the devastation. El libro de Joel es un libro poético y también es un libro de profecía. Escrito por un profeta en el Antiguo Testamento y dentro de los libros de los profetas menores. Amen. Y tiene un tono ominoso. Gloria al Señor. El primer capítulo habla de la invasión de langostas que destruye la tierra de Israel. Las langostas devoran la tierra hasta la desolación. Su vegetación, la tierra, sufren de la devastación de las langostas. En una escena horrible, Judá está, pues parece que está castigado, amén, por la devastación de la tierra de Israel. It's a horrible scene in Judah as the land is suffering from the devastation. It was once fertile, but now it is empty, it is barren. It is devastated by the plague of the locusts. Está, horrible la situación en Judá. Amen. Ahora es, están sufriendo la tierra, está sufriendo el pueblo de Israel. Amen. Y el capítulo 2 comienza con Dios diciéndole a Judá que hay una nueva amenaza de langostas. So after chapter 1, and where the desolation of the langostas. The langostas. I'm trying to remember my words in English too. The locust. Amen. After the desolation of chapter 1 with the locust, God comes and tells the people in chapter 2 that a new trial was coming, and he was sending more locusts. I mean, they had just, gone through the devastation of what had happened in their land, and now God is sending a new locust threat. But what's interesting is that God says that these locusts would be an army. It would be an army of people, of men, that were sent by God himself. Imagine that. Think about that for a moment. That the locusts that are going to be coming to further devastate the land of Israel were sent by God. Think about that for a minute. That's an ominous, a crazy prophetic word. These are supposed to be God's people. These are supposed to be the chosen people of God. Amen? En el capítulo 2 comienza Dios a diciendo a la gente que va a llegar una nueva amenaza de langostas. Pero estos langostas van a llegar en forma de un ejército dirigido por Dios mismo, mandado al pueblo de Israel a destruir todo, completamente todo, y están dirigidos por Dios mismo. Imagina cómo se sentía el pueblo de Israel. Ellos eran los escogidos de Dios, el pueblo de Dios, y ahora Dios está diciendo que Él va a mandar langostas en forma de un ejército para destruir la tierra, para destruir a ellos, para destruir al pueblo de Dios. ¡Wow! Y todo esto fue debido al pecado del pueblo, porque el pueblo estaba en y viviendo en pecado. All this because of the sin of the people. All this because the people were living in sin. They were outright disobedient to God. Now, Joel doesn't specifically state their sin, but we know from earlier writings that they had been unfaithful to God. They had been unfaithful to the commands of God. They had been disobedient to the will of God. Entendemos que todo esto fue debido al pecado de la gente, del pueblo de Israel. No declara específicamente qué era el pecado del pueblo, pero entendemos que ellos estaban infiel a Dios. Estaban desobedientes a la ley de Dios, desobedientes a la palabra de Dios. Ellos han dejado el camino de Dios. Andaban en pecado, en contra, amén, la voluntad de Dios. Así vivía esta nación de Israel. Amén. Estaban infieles a su llamado, infieles en su adoración a Dios. Ellos adoraban a dioses falsos. Amén. No habían guardado los mandamientos o preceptos de Jehová, su Dios. They had been worshiping false gods. They didn't obey the word of God. They had, failed to be faithful in their commitment to God. Instead, giving themselves over to the heathen gods and the customs of the heathen nations around them. They had been unfaithful to the call of God in their lives. They had intermingled with heathen tribes. They adopted their customs for their own. They adopted their traditions. The judgment that God brought upon the people of Israel was because and the result of their disobedience. They were disobedient. So the judgment that came was a result of their attitudes, a result of how they lived. Amen. Se habían mezclado con tribus paganos. Habían adoptado los costumbres y tradiciones de estos tribus. Aleluya. Su juicio fue el resultado de su desobediencia. Desobediencia a la ley de Dios, a su promesa a Dios. Estaban ellos desobedientes a los mandamientos de Dios. Aleluya. Adoraban a otros dioses, mezclaban con otros tribus paganos. Gloria a Dios. Así es de que esto era la resulta de su desobediencia. Eran los resultados de la desobediencia. ¿Cuántos saben que hay resultados de desobediencia? Amén. Gloria al Señor. Y es en este trasfondo de esta desolación que Joel habla de una venida día del Señor. Va a llegar un día del Señor que traerá un tormento final a la tierra. Que traerá un tormento a la tierra. So it's in the backdrop of this desolation that Joel speaks of a coming day of the Lord. He says, the day of the Lord is coming. The day of the Lord is coming. The day of the Lord will bring a final torment to the land of Israel. The day of the Lord will bring about the demise of the land of Israel. The demise of the land of Israel and its people. This army that is led by God himself, amen, will bring about the final judgment over the nation. This is what God is telling the people of Israel in chapter 2. I mean, it's bad news all the way around, right? Bad news. Who wants to hear this? Right? Who wants to hear bad news? Who wants to hear that you're going to lose out, that you're going to miss out, that everything that you work for is going to be destroyed? Who wants to hear that? Yet this is the tone of Joel chapter 2. This is the tone of how it begins. El día del Señor traerá la desparación de la tierra y el pueblo de Dios. Este ejército dirigido por Dios traerá el juicio final sobre la nación. ¡Qué malas noticias! ¡Qué malas noticias están viniendo al pueblo de Dios! Imagina cómo se sentía después de los langostas que destruyó toda la tierra. Ahora Dios está diciendo que va a traer un día del Señor que va finalmente destruir lo que queda. Qué malas noticias. Amén. Qué malas noticias estamos recibiendo aquí. Joel, ¿qué está diciendo? ¿Qué está diciendo? ¿Qué nos está compartiendo? Estamos compartiendo malas noticias. No queremos escuchar esto. No queremos pasar por esto. We don't want to pass through this. We don't want to hear this, right? But in the certainty of their fate, In the certainty of the fate that God was bringing them, he gives them one more opportunity to turn the tide. He gives them one more opportunity to turn things around. He gives them one more opportunity to repent. One more chance to turn away and repent, to avert the terrible judgment that is coming. En la certeza de este destino, de lo que Dios le han dicho al pueblo, Dios le da una oportunidad más para cambiar el rumbo de su juicio. Para cambiar, aleluya, y le iba a dar una oportunidad más para volver con Dios, a volver a la voluntad de Dios, a volver, y le da una oportunidad más para arrepentirse y evitar el juicio que estaba acercando. Le da una oportunidad más para arrepentirse de su pecado, arrepentirse de lo que estaba pasando, arrepentirse de lo que estaba haciendo el pueblo de Dios. He offers them one opportunity for true repentance. He offers them an opportunity to repent. Repentance, what is repentance? Repentance is to turn away from. It is an about face. It is a complete reversal. That is repentance. God was saying, Joel says, listen, God says, we can have one more chance. Joel pleads with the people and he tells them, listen, it's time for us to repent. Let's turn back to God. Let's turn back to God. Le ofrece una oportunidad más para arrepentimiento verdadero. El arrepentimiento es alejarse de, es un cambio de actitud, un cambio total. Y Joel está diciendo a la gente, mira, hay oportunidad para arrepentirnos. Esta oportunidad que Dios nos está dando es una oportunidad de arrepentirnos de nuestros malos hechos. Gloria al Señor. Arrepentirnos del pecado. Dios nos está dando una oportunidad más antes de la venida del día del Señor. Antes de la venida del juicio, tenemos una oportunidad de arrepentirnos. Gloria al Señor. El arrepentimiento es la única forma de evitar cierto juicio. La única forma de cambiar la ira de Dios por su misericordia. Gloria a Dios. Repentance is the only way to avert certain judgment. Repentance is the only way to trade God's wrath for his mercy. It is the only way to escape the judgment of God. We must repent. Israel, we must repent. It's the only way we're going to survive. It's the only way that our land will once again bring vegetation. It's the only way that we are going to be able to live. We must repent, Israel. We need to repent. God has given us one more chance. God has given us one more opportunity. The day of the Lord hasn't yet come. There is still yet another opportunity. It's time to repent. Time to repent. God wants them to seek not simply a behavior modification, but a heart transformation. Listen, God don't care about your behavior modification, right? Behavior modification never gets us anywhere, right? God doesn't necessarily want us to change our habits. He wants us to transform our hearts. He wants us to transform our hearts. Joel le dice, hay que comprometernos a dar vuelta de nuestro pecado con todo nuestro corazón, porque Dios quiere y Dios busque no simplemente una modificación de comportamiento, sino una transformación del corazón. Eso es lo que Dios busca, una transformación de corazón, aleluya, no, un cambio en nuestros hábitos, no un cambio de nuestro comportamiento, pero una transformación verdadera, una transformación del corazón. Eso es lo que busca el Señor, y eso es lo que estaba comunicando la profeta Joel al pueblo de Israel. Mira, Dios quiere que nos transformamos nuestros corazones. Y hay oportunidad, hay una oportunidad para nosotros que podemos tomar este tiempo de arrepentirnos y transformar nuestros corazones. Gloria al Señor. Habla del duelo, del llanto, del ayuno. Luego le dice que rasguen sus corazones, no sus vestidos. Gloria al Señor. He speaks of mourning, of weeping, fasting. Then Joel tells the people, rend your hearts, not your garments. Rend your hearts, not your garments. In other words, tear your hearts, not your garments. In Jewish tradition, grief and remorse was expressed outwardly with ashes and sackcloth. In other words, when you were grieving and remorseful, you would pour ashes over your head and you'd tear your clothes. Right? And that was a way that they ceremonially expressed grief and remorse. It was ceremonial. En la tradición de los judíos, el dolor y remordimiento se expresaron externamente con cenizas y el rompimiento del saco o de la ropa. In other words, the mourner, as they poured ashes over their heads and tore their garments, it was to outwardly express, so everybody would know that they're grieving, so everybody would know that they had remorse, right? En otras palabras, el doliente derramaba ceniza sobre su cabeza, rasgaba sus vestiduras para demostrar ceremonialmente el dolor y remordimiento del corazón. Entonces Dios dice, rasguen sus corazones, no sus vestiduras. En otras palabras, Él no quiere dolor o remordimiento ceremonial. No lo quiere ceremonial. What God is saying, when He tells them to tear their hearts, not their garments, He does not want ceremonial grief or remorse. He doesn't want anything that is, ceremonial, that's not heartfelt, right? He don't want you just to check off a box, right? That's not what God is saying. Listen, grief, I want you to hear me now. If you're taking notes, I want you to listen to this. Grief is an indication of loss, right? Grief is an indication of loss. Remorse is regret for a transgression, right? Which at times can lead us to guilt. El dolor es un indicio de pérdida. Si me están oyendo, quiero que se tomen estas notas. El dolor es un indicio de pérdida y el remordimiento es arrepentimiento por una transgresión que a veces incluso puede conducir a la culpa. Amén. En todos esos casos, estas emociones solo mantienen, sígueme bien, solo mantienen a la persona atada a su pecado y nunca puede conducir a la verdadera liberación. Porque estás atada en la culpa. Estás atada por esa emoción de culpa. Por eso cuando hay veces que llegamos aquí al templo y escuchamos el equipo de adoración cantando y podemos sentir la presencia del Señor entrar en el edificio, pero no podemos ni levantar ningún dedo. No podemos levantar ningún dedo en adoración a Dios. No podemos cantar libremente porque estamos atados por culpa. Estamos atados por la culpa de nuestro pecado, por la culpa de lo que estamos haciendo, por la culpa de las amenazas del diablo que llega diariamente y nos recuerde de nuestras fallas, de nuestros las cosas que hemos hecho durante la semana, y ahí estamos atados por la culpa del pecado. Gloria al Señor. In all these cases, emotions, amen, loss, remorse, regret, they only keep a person bound to sin. That's all they do. And it can never lead to true liberation. This is why when you come into a place like this and you feel the atmosphere and you can feel, the worship team worshiping and getting into worship, getting into praise, and you know that God is present, but you can't even lift a finger, much less your hand. You can't even open your mouth to praise God because you're so bound by guilt. So bound by guilt. The guilt of my sin, the guilt of what I've done wrong, the guilt of my participation in the things that I ought not to be doing, in the places I ought not to be at, doing the things that I should not be involved in. So my guilt gets a hold of me. I'm grieving because of my guilt. I'm remorseful for what I've done, but that guilt don't let us go. Doesn't allow us to worship freely. Doesn't allow us to praise God freely. Doesn't allow us to live for God freely. Doesn't allow us to minister freely. Because we're so bound by guilt. So God tells the people of Israel, look, I want something deeper. I don't want ceremonial, guilt. I don't want ceremonial, things that you can offer me. I don't want sackcloth and ashes. I want something deeper. I want true repentance. True repentance can only come through conviction. Can only come through conviction. Listen to this. Conviction is an acknowledgement of wrongdoing and a validation of the offense. Right? Are you following me? Yo quería algo más profundo. Para que el pueblo de Israel llegar a la liberación, Dios quería algo más profundo que las cenizas. Amen. Más profundo que el ceremonia. Dios quería verdadero arrepentimiento que comienza con la convicción. Comienza con la convicción. Escúchame bien. La convicción es un reconocimiento de la mala conducta y una validación del delito. ¿Me están siguiendo? Aleluya. Cuando eres condenado por un crimen, el crimen se valida por el convicción. Amén. La condena valida el crimen. He hecho mal. He pecado. Valida el pecado. Valida el crimen. Listen. When you are convicted of the crime, the offense is validated, right? When you're convicted of a crime, now you are validated. The crime is validated, right? When you're convicted of robbing, the crime is validated, right? Are you following me? Conviction validates the offense. I have done wrong. I have sinned. Conviction validates the offense. I have offended God. I have sinned. When the prophet Nathan came to David and he expressed David's sin and he talked to him, what did David say? He says, I have sinned against God. Right? I have sinned. Conviction validated the offense. Right? Conviction validates the offense. I'm going to drive this home because I want you to understand something here. Cuando eres condenado por un crimen, el crimen se valida. ¿Te recuerdas que David, cuando la profeta Nathan se vino a él? Él dijo, yo he pecado en contra a Dios. Amén. El convicción del corazón del rey David validó, aleluya, el pecado. Gloria al Señor. Ahora, la convicción no solo valida la ofensa, sino que revela el condición del ofensor. Soy un pecador. He pecado y soy un pecador. ¿Me está siguiendo? Aleluya. Now, conviction not only validates the offense, but it reveals the condition of the sinner. I have sinned. I am a sinner. Are you following me? Right? Conviction validates the offense. I have sinned. I have sinned against God. But it also reveals our condition. I am a sinner. Right? Reveals our condition. Now, why is this important? Because it is necessary to the process of repentance. It's necessary. The conviction has to come, amen, so that it will validate the offense. I have sinned. And then it reveals the condition of the sinner. This is a process of repentance. It is not only an acknowledgement of sin, follow me now, but a recognition of our condition. Amen. Esto es necesario para el proceso de arrepentimiento, porque el arrepentimiento es un proceso. No es solo un reconocimiento de pecado, sino un reconocimiento de nuestra condición. Amén. Todos somos en esta condición. Nadie de nosotros somos perfectos. Todos de nosotros sufrimos. Amén. Todos nosotros sufrimos y luchamos en contra de nuestra carne, de nuestros deseos. Amén. De la condición de nuestros corazones, que siempre batalla en contra del Espíritu. Que siempre lucha en contra del Espíritu, que siempre lucha en contra la palabra de Dios. Es por eso que hay algunos de nosotros que no se sienten cómodos ahorita. ¿Ah? ¿Cuándo va a terminar el pastor para que podamos felicitar a los hermanos por el año nuevo y podamos agarrar nuestro chocoflan que nos espera? That's why when we hear messages like this, sometimes it makes us uncomfortable. Can't wait for it to finish so we can go and greet the brothers, tell them happy birthday, and enjoy our choco flan. I don't know if they have choco flan ready, but. Right? So Joel tells the people, listen, it's time to repent. Time to turn away from our evil ways. Time to turn back to God. It's time to turn to God so we can avoid the judgment that's coming. Joel understands this. Check this out. Joel understands that there is only one thing more powerful than the judgment of God, and that is his mercy. Joel le dice a la gente que es tiempo de arrepentirse. Tiene que apartarse de los malos caminos, volverse a Dios para evitar el juicio que está acercando al pueblo de Israel. Joel entiende que hay una sola cosa más grande que el juicio de Dios, y es su misericordia. Amén. La misericordia de Dios es más grande que su juicio. Recuerde que la misericordia es no recibir lo que se merece. Esa es la misericordia. La misericordia de Dios es la que evite el desastre. Gloria al Señor. La misericordia de Dios es poderoso. Nos protege, nos guíe, nos cubre. Gloria al Señor. Por eso hay que buscar la misericordia de Dios. Remember, mercy is not receiving what you deserve. That's what mercy is. I remember when my dad would tell me, hey, mijo, you're not behaving in church. You're going to have to get a whipping when you get home. You're going to have to get a lick or two when you get home. You get home, and then mama says, let him sleep. He's tired. That's mercy. That's mercy. Thank God for mercy. My dad had a big belt, a big buckle. First Apostolic Church of Salinas. I'll never forget that belt. Me and Sally hid that. I feel to this day he can't find it. Thank you, Jesus. That's mercy. Not receiving what you deserve. The mercy of God is what will spare his people. The mercy of God is what will bring blessing instead of cursing. The mercy of God is what will bring life instead of death. The mercy of God is what will stay the judgment of God. La misericordia de Dios es que perdonará al pueblo. La misericordia de Dios es que aplaca y trae bendición en lugar de maldición. La misericordia de Dios trae vida en lugar de la muerte. Es la misericordia de Dios que detenga el juicio de Dios. Hay que buscar la misericordia de Dios. Gloria al Señor. El verdadero arrepentimiento activará la misericordia de Dios en nuestras vidas. Activa la misericordia de Dios en la vida del pecador y restablecerá la promesa del creyente. El verdadero arrepentimiento libera. Gloria al Señor. True repentance will activate the mercy of God in the life of the sinner and reinstate the promise of the believer. True repentance liberates. True repentance sets us free. It sets us free from guilt. Hallelujah. And remorse. True repentance will set us free. That's what Joel is telling the people. Listen, we need to repent. Now you might wonder, what does this have to do with outpour, Pastor Jeremy? I thought we were just going to run, jump, going to have a Holy Ghost. I mean, I was just going to pour out, right? I was waiting for, that's why I came. I could have stayed home. I could have had a V8, right? Ahora, puede preguntarse, ¿qué tiene esto que ver con el derramamiento? Dios dijo al pueblo de Israel, hay que arrepentirse. Joel dijo, hay que arrepentirse, pueblo de Israel. Es tiempo. Tiene que entender que el capítulo 2 de Joel termina. Muchas veces queremos escuchar los versículos 28 a 32 que habla del derramamiento en los días antiguos. Amén. O en los días postreros. Pero la verdad es que el capítulo 12 de Joel empieza con arrepentimiento. Empieza con arrepentimiento. ¿Qué quiero decir? Quiero decir que el derramamiento no es una causa, son los resultados. No son la causa, son los resultados. No puedes llegar al derramamiento y salir del arrepentimiento. Are you listening? Are you following me? Listen. You got to understand, Joel chapter 2 ends with outpour. A lot of times we want to go to verse 28 to 32, which talks about the outpour. In the last days I'll pour out my spirit. And we're going to get there. But Joel chapter 2 begins with repentance. Begins with repentance. Listen to this. I want you to understand this. Follow me with this. Outpour is not a cause. Outpour is a result. Outpour is not a cause. It is a result. You can't get to outpour by skipping repentance. You can't get to outpour by skipping repentance. Message for today. Real simple. I came with a simple message today, folks. The message today is repent. Not sexy. It's not something that's going to knock your socks off. It's not something that's, you know, that you're going to write home and tell mom and dad about. It's a simple message, repent. Right? Simple message. El mensaje para nosotros hoy es simple y es arrepentirse. Arrepentirse. Amen. Este tal vez no es un mensaje que vamos a correr o vamos a you know, decir, you know, estar, you know, cantando, brincando, corriendo, haciendo todas esas cosas que queremos hacer. Pero es un mensaje necesario, porque no podemos llegar al derramamiento sin el arrepentimiento. Tenemos que arrepentirnos hoy. Tenemos que arrepentirnos hoy. Tengo una confesión para hacer. Durante estos últimos 6 meses he estado sintiendo algo que me estaba molestando mi espíritu. Sintiendo que Dios quería derramar su espíritu en grande manera, en una manera milagrosa. Y de hecho hemos visto algunos domingos que hemos visto la, el movimiento del Espíritu Santo. Amén. Hemos visto personas que son sanados de enfermedades, liberados, amén, de todas diferentes cosas y espíritus malignos y maldiciones. Hemos visto a Dios hacer lo imposible. Hemos visto a Dios a mover en nuestras familias, en nuestros hogares, en nuestros ministerios. Hemos visto a Dios hacer cosas maravillosas. Pero de hecho, en esto, aleluya, hemos encontrado también una oposición extrema, una oposición del movimiento de Dios extrema en esta iglesia. I'm telling the folks that I got a confession to make. Listen, the last 6 months, I felt God wanting to move powerfully in our midst. I felt an urge to see the power of God move and fall and pour out in miraculous ways. And we've seen little things that God has done. We've seen people come to the church and be healed in their infirmities. We've seen people be liberated from curses and from devils and all these things that have plagued them. And we've seen God move in the miraculous. We've seen God bless lives and touch homes and touch relationships and do the impossible. We've seen Him do it. We've seen Him do it. But in the midst of all this, in the midst of the glimpses of outpour that we have seen, we have been met with extreme opposition. Extreme opposition. Seemed like for every step forward we take 3 steps back. Frustrating. As your pastor, it's been frustrating. Strife among leadership. People can't get along. Fighting personal offenses. Actually rooting for people to fail. Yeah, I'm going there. So I'm tired of it. Expecting the worst of people. Listening to every single little chisme that comes around. Giving ear to it instead of stopping it. All that leading to division, dissension, discontent. People walk into the house. I'm gonna greet Brother Jess, but I'm not going to greet Brother Rudy. I'm going to make it a point to avoid him. Told you it was going to hurt. Hemos visto muchas diferentes cosas suceder. Por cada paso que damos, parece que hay 3 pasos atrás. Conflictos entre líderes que no puede, que no puede aguantar. Oh, ese hermano, cómo me cae gordo. Esa hermana, pues no sé. Hay 10 domingos que no lo veo. Hablando uno del otro. Luchando contra ofensas personales, división, disensión, descontento, chismes. Ese demonio de chisme. ¿Ah? Y estos tal vez son ataques espirituales. Son ataques espirituales. Pero convenientemente señalamos con el dedo al enemigo y le decimos: es tu culpa. Tú eres el causa de todo esto. Pero la verdad, aunque él no es inocente, creo que la verdad del asunto es que la gran parte de la oposición son nuestras propias actitudes pecaminosas y orgullosas. I'm saying about all this strife and amongst your leadership and relationships, and y'all can't get along and all this silly stuff that you hold on to, that you allow to steal from you, that you allow for the devil to rob you. Remain seated there and stay where you're at, letting letting the outpour pass you by. Right? A lot of times we look at this and there are no doubt spiritual attacks. Don't get me wrong. They are spiritual attacks. But too often we conveniently point the finger at the enemy and say, you did this. You caused this. Devil, you're a liar. I'm not saying that he's blameless. But I believe the truth of the matter is that the source of much of this is our own pride, our own disobedience, our own sin. It's time to repent. It's time to repent. You want outpour? You need to repent. We got one believer here. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. All I need is one. I want you to understand something. God was sending an army. God was sending an army to destroy Israel. Their sin had made them an enemy of God himself. Dios estaba enviando un ejército para destruir a Israel. Su pecado lo había convertido a un enemigo de Dios mismo. Entiéndeme. ¿Podríamos realmente perder nuestra promesa y en cambio provocar conflictos? Yo creo que sí podemos. God was sending an army to destroy Israel. Their sin had made them an enemy of God. I said, think about this. Could we actually forfeit our promise and instead bring about strife? Could we actually do that? Could we actually forfeit the promise that God has for us and instead bring about strife? I believe we can. And I believe we have. I believe we have. Struggle to get volunteers to serve. Why? Associate pastors were telling me about how they're trying to put things on and people promise to come and people promise to be a part, and then they don't show up. Some of that includes ministers and pastors. Why? I don't like the person in charge. Time to repent. Struggle to get leaders to commit to service. You have time for everything else, but come to God? Nowhere to be found. Why? Folks struggle just to get to church as if God owed them something. Why? And then God's family struggles to get along. Why? I know all of us are planning to get to heaven. You better get used to one another if you're planning to get to heaven. You're going to be together a long time. And he's going to make your neighbor that brother that you just can't get along with. You have to wake up and see his smile for eternity. Luchamos para conseguir voluntarios para servir. ¿Por qué? Líderes luchan por comprometerse con excelencia. ¿Por qué? La gente lucha solo para llegar a la iglesia. ¿Por qué? La familia de Dios lucha por llevarse bien. ¿Por qué? ¿Ah? Es tiempo de arrepentirnos. Arrepentirnos. Ahora bien, si tu respuesta a cualquiera de estas preguntas es una serie de quejas, señalar el dedo a culpar a otros, al diablo, al pastor, al hermano, entonces has probado mi caso. Es tiempo de arrepentirse. Es tan fácil hoy, en estos días, para renunciar a nuestras responsabilidades, renunciar a nuestros ministerios, renunciar a nuestro matrimonio, renunciar a la vocación, renunciar a nuestro camino a Dios. Pero ¿por qué? Porque pues estoy herido, estoy cansado, estoy enojado, o mi favorito, no estoy de acuerdo. Eso es mi favorito, no estoy de acuerdo. Me pregunto a veces que en dónde estaríamos si Jesús renunciara cuando él estaba cansado, cuando él estaba lastimado, cuando él estaba enojado o no estuviera de acuerdo. I'm saying, I'm telling the folks, listen, if your answer to all these questions is a series of complaints, finger pointing, assigning blame on everyone from the devil to the pastor or even God himself, you prove my case for repentance. Because today it's easy to quit. So easy to quit. Easy to quit my ministry. It's easy to quit my marriage. Easy to quit my calling. Easy to quit my walk with God because I'm hurt, because I'm tired, because I'm angry, or my personal favorite because I don't agree. That's my favorite. I don't agree. I wonder where Jesus would be if he quit, or where we would be if Jesus quit when he got tired, when he got hurt, when he got angry, or he didn't agree. He wanted to. You remember the Garden of Gethsemane when he was praying? The Bible says he prayed with such intensity that the beads of sweat on his forehead turned to blood. And he told God, listen, Father, let this cup pass from me. I don't want to do this. I know what's coming. I know that I'm going to have to go through this ugly death, and they're still not going to love you. They're still not going to follow you. They're still going to fight you. I don't want to go through this. I don't want to feel this pain. I'm tired. I'm hurt. I'm angry. I'm being taken advantage of. God, I don't agree with this. Why don't we just stop this and start all over? I don't want to go through this. I don't want to be beat. I don't want to be cut. I don't want to be crucified. I don't want to go through this for a people that will not love you. Nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. Padre, no quiero llegar, no quiero que esta copa me llegue, no quiero sentir los golpes, no quiero sentir la crucificación, no quiero pasar por esto. Al fin, al cabo, ellos no quieren servirte, ellos no le aman a ti, Señor. Señor, mi Padre, deja que este castigo me pase. No quiero pasar por esta lucha. Ten misericordia de mí. Pero no quiero mi voluntad. Voy a seguir. Voy a hacer esto. Voy a sacrificar. Voy a derramar mi sangre, porque es tu voluntad, Señor, no mío. Listen, we need to repent today. I want you to stand with me. Tenemos que arrepentirnos hoy. We need to repent of our complacency. Repent of our complacency, the way we serve God. I want you to think about that. And if the shoe fits, put it on. Think about the way that we serve God and the way that we serve ourselves. Are the scales even? I want outpour. This is where it begins. Our complacency. Repent of our lackadaisical service, giving the leftovers to God. I don't know how many times I tell leaders we need to serve in excellence. We need to serve in excellence. And you still put your program on a half hour before it's ready to start. Repent of your offenses. Offenses build fences, folks. And oftentimes the fence is you in, not your offender. Let it go. Repent of your pride. Repent of your arrogance. Stop acting like God owes you salvation. Truth is, not one drop of blood do any of us deserve. Any of us. Repent from our lack of commitment. Repent from our refusal to raise a standard. Repent that we take our salvation for granted. It's time to repent. Hay que arrepentirnos de nuestra complacencia, la manera en cómo vivimos, servimos a Dios. Si servimos a nosotros mismos mejor que a Dios, hay un problema. Arrepentirnos de nuestro servicio indiferente, hay que ofrecer lo excelente a Dios. Hay que ofrecer lo mejor a Dios. Arrepentirse de nuestras ofensas. Las ofensas crean barreras. No queremos barreras en este tiempo, en este momento de derramamiento. Arrepentirnos de nuestro orgullo, de nuestra arrogancia, de nuestra falta de compromiso, de nuestro rechazo de levantar un estándar. Arrepentirnos que hemos tomado nuestra salvación por otorgado. Si arrepentimos, Dios traerá restauración. Si arrepentimos, Dios demanda el derramamiento que Él lo prometió. Pero tenemos que comenzar con el arrepentimiento. Es tiempo, iglesia. Es tiempo, aleluya, de arrepentirnos, de dejarnos estas cosas y venir al trono de Dios con una actitud mejor. It's time to repent. It's time to repent. It's time to come to the throne of God with a different attitude. It's time to come to the throne of God with a different attitude. Listen, God has so much that He wants to do through each of you, through each of your ministries. God wants to do so much through you. And God wants to allow for this outpour to just run through this entire county, this entire state. But to get there, we must repent. We need to approach the throne of God differently. We need to approach the throne of God, hallelujah, with a heart of thanksgiving, with a heart of repentance. Allow for God to remove all those things that held us back. We can't take that into 2022 because what God has for you is so much greater. Don't allow yourself to be robbed any longer. Don't allow for the locusts to come up and eat away at your promise, to eat away at the things that God has for you, to eat away at the harvest that God is bringing for you. Understand that this outpour isn't just about you, but it's about those that come after you. This is about little Rudy. This is about Zach. This is about Zoe. This is about people that aren't even here yet. Don't shortchange them because of your pride. Don't shortchange them because of your arrogance. It's time to repent. Listen, the last 2 weeks while you all have been with your families, I've been with my family, has been a process of repentance for me. You see, the thing about a message is when God gives you a message, He doesn't give you words. He doesn't just give you words to put on a piece of paper. God brings you something and says, listen, son, you've been complacent too long. It's time for you to repent. Get on your knees and repent. You've tolerated too much, pastor. You've allowed the wolf to come into the proverbial hen house. You've stood by. I'm being transparent. Because I going into 2022, I want nothing but the outpour. I'm not too prideful that I can't lay it down for Jesus. As a matter of fact, I shouldn't even be here. What do I got to lose? I said, Pastor, you've allowed too much to go by. You've tolerated too much. You've allowed for these evil spirits and evil issues to overtake the promise that I had for you. So it's time for you to repent. It's time for you to repent. Repent. Repent of your complacency. Repent of your laziness. Repent of your attitude. Repent of your lackadaisical expectation of the people of God, Pastor. Don't be afraid to get to them for me, because what you are doing is you are my voice, and they need to hear what thus saith the Lord. It's not always going to be pretty. It's not always going to be accepted, and you're not always going to be loved, but neither was I. So repent and do what I've called you to do. Durante estos últimos dos semanas que ustedes estaban con sus familias compartiendo el tiempo de esta temporada, yo también estuve con mi familia, pero durante estas dos semanas Dios me llevó a un altar de arrepentimiento. Un altar de arrepentimiento. Y me dijo, ¿sabes qué, pastor? Tú tienes que arrepentirse porque has dejado por espíritus malignos a entrar en la familia de Dios. Has dejado tu puesto. Has dejado que el enemigo se corre entre los hermanos y la familia de Dios. Y es tiempo que tú tomas, tu llamamiento. Es tiempo que tú tomas el lugar en que te he puesto. Hermano pastor, tú tienes que arrepentirse. Y estoy siendo muy transparente, hermanos, porque todo de nosotros, para que llegue el derramamiento que Dios nos ha prometido, todo de nosotros tenemos que arrepentirnos. El profeta Joel, cuando llamó al pueblo de Israel, lo llamó, mira, ayuna conmigo, ore conmigo, arrepentir conmigo. Porque nosotros, como un pueblo de Dios, como una nación, tenemos que buscar la misericordia de Dios. Tenemos que buscar su misericordia para detener el juicio que llega. Entonces hoy, por mi familia en línea también, que nos está siguiendo, les quiero decir esto. Si ustedes están a cercas de Salinas, si ustedes están en el condado de Monterrey, es tiempo que se llegue aquí a la iglesia. Si estás afuera, si estás en otro país, si estás en otro estado y no puedes llegar, pues está bien quien nos asiste en las redes sociales. Pero si estás aquí, es tiempo de llegar aquí a la iglesia. Es tiempo que se llegue aquí a la iglesia para estar aquí con la familia de Dios. Porque es tiempo que dejar esas cosas para atrás. Amén. Es tiempo que llegar aquí a la iglesia para que esté en persona, para que ustedes puedan escuchar la palabra de Dios en persona, para que usted pueda sentir el calor, aleluya, de los hermanos que están aquí con ustedes, que están orando por ustedes, que están velando por ustedes, amén, que están en camino con ustedes, porque nosotros vamos al mismo lugar, tenemos la misma meta, queremos llegar al cielo juntos. And for my friends online, I'm saying, listen, if you're in Salinas, if you're in Monterey County, it's time for you to get to church. Don't stay home anymore. Don't stay home anymore. If you're sick, if you're ill, or if you're out of town, or if you're wherever you are, that's fine. But if you're able-bodied, if you're breathing, and you're in Salinas, California, you're in Monterey County, get to church already. No more. No more. It's time to get back to God's house, because what God wants to bring is something extraordinary. Don't allow for yourself to be robbed one moment longer. Don't be lazy. Don't put anything else before it. Put your relationship with God first. Listen, when you put God first, He'll put everything in your life in its order. I encourage you. And for those of you that don't know Jesus, and you want to know Jesus, repent of your sins. Repent of your wrongdoings. Throw yourself at the mercy of the court, and I guarantee you, God will show you mercy. He will show up in the middle of your circumstance, in the middle of your issue, and He will save you. Hermanos, vamos a orar por nuestra familia en línea. En el nombre de Jesucristo, te pido, Señor, que tú, Señor, bendice a estos hogares. Dirígenos, Señor, en este espíritu de arrepentimiento. En este espíritu de arrepentimiento, Señor, porque necesitamos a ti, Señor. Necesitamos a ti en nuestra vida, Señor, para seguir en 2022, Señor. Queremos llegar al derramamiento, Señor, pero sabemos que tenemos que pasar por el arrepentimiento. Y aquí estamos, Señor, con manos en alto, Señor, pidiendo tu misericordia. Pidiendo tu misericordia, Padre. In the name of Jesus, I pray for our families and our homes, God. I pray right now, God, that you, Father, would lead us to the place of outpour, God, but that we would get there through way of repentance, God. So we repent from our sins, God, and we pray for your mercy, God. Have mercy on your people. Show up right now in the name of Jesus. Listen, those of you online, the outpour is here, but there's a process from repentance to restoration to renewal. I can't wait to talk to you about restoration next week. It's going to blow your mind. In Jesus' name, we love you guys. Thank you for being with us. God bless you.